Hello fellow modelers and styling fanatics, welcome back to my channel. I hope that everyone is doing fine and enjoys the hobby. My name is George and I'm once again broadcasting from the Concrete Bunker with a freshly baked new update. Today's update is all about a mail call, our progress on the Panzer 1 from Italy, and the showcase of my girlfriend's work because she asked me to ask you your opinion. You guys know the drill? The time has come for you to grab a seat and crack the mandatory cold remedy that's going to help you get through this update. You have been warned, ready or not, here I go. First of all, I'm going to start with my girlfriend's request. Because you know how it gets with women. Don't you dare to say no. Or else you're gonna find yourself outside, living in the dog's house. And the thing here is, my dog has no house outside, he lives inside. So, me and my girlfriend both love Christmas, and we usually start doing Christmas stuff 2 months before, like today. So, the last few days she's making these small canvases that are Christmas themed. Let me show you what I mean. We have a cat wrapped around Christmas bulbs saying Happy Catmas. We have a moose that his horns have Christmas, you know, the Christmas balls. Well, that doesn't sound it okay, but anyway. We have one of my personal favorites, which is those two snowmen looking at the stars in the middle of the night. We have an American guy, probably, because I don't know why this track remembers me of an American track, or the Griswold family just grabbed their tree, and we have the one that she made especially for me, Snoopy, in his house waiting for Christmas with all the Christmas balls over here. Finally, because we are over here a little bit Dungeons and Dragons, we have dwarves. Let me give you a final look of all those. We have three over here. Ooh, no. And these three. We would love to know your opinions, guys, in the comment section below. And so please help me stay in the home. Help me stay at home. So, right now, I want you to give me some time to reposition my camera so we can move on to with our second part of this update. Camera is repositioned and we are ready to go. Now let's move to my mail call. Quite a while ago I was talking to Jeff from Smoky Mountain Modeler. However, whoever is not familiar with his work, I am going to leave a link to his channel on the description section below, you know, somewhere here in the edge of your screen. Jeff is a fellow military modeler. His work on those military kits is to say at least amazing. He pays attention to detail and his weathering is excellent. So please guys, go check him out and give him a sub. As I said, I was talking to him one day and discussion go like that. He had two dragon kits. One of them was a stug and the other one was an elephant that he wanted to sell, and he had he had put them on eBay. So I asked him, give me your eBay name so I can find you because I want to buy one of those kits. He immediately told me in which kit I am interested. And I told him that I am interested in the elephant kit. So he told me, give me your address and I'm gonna send it to you for free. But I want you to make a build out of it. And of course, Jeff, I'm gonna make a build out of it. There is no question. So I sent him my address and here is what I have got back. Give me a moment. Sorry guys, the box is a bit huge. He sent me this little beauty. This is an SDK FZ184, the elephant from Dragon in 1 to 35th scale, and kit number 6126. My god, the box is so huge. This is gonna be, definitely be a build in a couple of episodes. And apart this one, he also had another nice surprise that I had no idea inside the box. And it was this little beauty in gentleman scale, as Charlie Mack says, is 1 to 72nd. Is a TAF-55A dash up to AM from Revell. This is gonna be really interesting because I want to build something in gentleman scale because I believe that's gonna be a nice practice for me to move to something smaller, you know, change of pace. So Jeff, thank you, my friend. I really appreciate it and it means a lot to me. You will definitely see both builds in the near future. I don't know in which order, but you're gonna definitely see them. And I can't thank you enough. Now, let's talk about our Panzer One. And give me another moment, guys, to again reposition my camera once again. My god, I do that a lot. And here it is. As you can see, the main assembly right now is finished. The only parts that are missing are the fenders in the front fenders and rear fenders, which I don't know if I'm gonna attach yet. The commander's hatch, which I left it in purpose for the end. The exhaust, which I'm gonna do, probably I'm gonna do a separate video about it, and you're gonna see why. And the Pioneer tools and the weathering. So far the build is really nice. I'm having a blast with that because and I'm saying that because although it's an older kit, it goes together nicely, and I have no problem putting it together, no gaps or nothing. And because I have made a conclusion that I like small light tanks of World War II era. So Past George has a few things to say. I'm gonna stop the video right now, get him out of the cellar and show you. See you in a moment. Well, hello my fellow modelers and friends. I hope that everyone is doing fine today also. I don't think I'm gonna know because I'm out of the cellar and I am recording this from the past. As you can see in front of you, I have applied the Balkan camo on the Panzer 1. Most of the assembly is already finished, and I'm saying most because I'm gonna explain it to you later. As you can see, I have two coats of white and two coats of Panzer Grey. Turret is guns are removable, turret as well. So we've got a win-win situation over here. I had a little bit of a hard time tracing the camo pattern because the instructions weren't so clear. I didn't have a look from this side. I don't know the name, how I can call it in English. Anyway, let me show you. I have only these three. So from, I have the left side, I had to eyeball the right side, and I have this that helps me, let me grab a pointer, helps me imagine how it go from the upper side, and I mean this one. It's like a cow now. Maybe I should put it in a green field. Anyway, now that I have finished the main assembly, it is the dreary time for the tank tracks, which are over here, and another one over here, each one for each side. Instructions call that I'm gonna need 84 track links per side. Let me show you, give me a moment. So it is over here, it is 84 links, and I need the two lengths. So by my calculations, and I wanna believe that I am good at math, over here I have 90 links and the two lengths in each jar. I had cut them yesterday. Oh, hear me. Psst. Sorry, guys. That's a guy over there, and I don't know what he is doing right now. What he sees, anyway.
Oh, here.
So let's continue. Mild distraction. Over here, I have cut 90 lengths. As I said, I haven't cleaned them yet. As always, here is the pile, half of the pile, and let me grab a set of tweezers. Now I have to clean something like this. Remember, this is supposed to be fun. So I have to clean all these parts, 180 tracks, and start applying them all around the moving gear. Anyway, I'm gonna immediately start cleaning them, and we will see how it goes. After that, I am going to apply the rest detail pieces, what I wanna say by detail pieces, give me a moment to pick them all up, because I don't wanna miss anything. I never trust the instructions when they say 84 or 96 parts or whatever. So as always, I cut more. So now what's left of me to do after the tracks, of course, is to install all the highlighted pieces. Back from step 4 all the way to step 5, as you can see, and step 6, and finally step 7. Now, before I go, just for the record, I am thinking of leaving every fender off, and I mean the two front ones and the two rear ones, but I still don't know. We're gonna see what I'm gonna decide. You know me, I always decide when I get there. So, off to clean all those trucks and see you later. Bye bye. Good morning once again, my fellow modelers and friends. Past George is talking to you once again. I have managed to break myself out of the cellar that the other guy keeps me. And I'm here to talk about my update on the Cow Panzer. Look at this, guys. You cannot convince me otherwise. It is a cow. With a little bit of imagination, of course. So, the last 2 days I spent them cleaning and assembling tank trucks. In total amount, as I have said 2 seconds for you ago, 2 days for me ago, there were 190 links. I have managed to get them all clean, apart from two, and that's what's left from these two. It was a pretty difficult task because you needed to hold the part in your fingers like this, sand it like this, and be careful not to break it, and then turn it all around, hold it once again from the other side, and sand it again. With 190 links I have that I have sanded, a bit through my fingerprints. So right now I am the guy without fingerprints. If anyone is interested in a heist, he can contact me. So I have no fingerprints. Nobody can know who am I no more. So, obviously a joke. After the cleaning, I have managed to get them in one piece. It took me about 45 minutes for each side. This one is the right side. And this one is the left side. Left side is far better than the right, because at the right side I have made a boo-boo or a mistake. You can clearly see it over here. This is supposed to be more like a slope than an angle. It is supposed to, with a few words, it is supposed to be like this. But I have made a mistake and attached one more link. So here are the results. Anyway, I can live with that. It is what it is right now. Only the keen eye can see it. And only the keen eye will see it. The way I'm gonna position the tank. I am pretty happy with the assembly of those links. Although their size was small, everything fell together wonderfully, and as the glue was applied onto them, they were firm enough so I could fit them from the rear. And that's what's left for 4 spares. 3 pieces over here, 2.5 to be precise, and 2 pieces over here. This one used to be 3 pieces, but I have lost it during the time I was trying to record this video. So I'm gonna see what I'm gonna do. So with all that said and done, the Panzer has finished the biggest portion of its assembly. Right now what's left to be done is clearly the commander's hats, the pioneer tools, and the exhaust. That's the next part that I'm gonna focus right now. And then the weathering. That was all for this update, my friends. See you the next time. At the next time. Bye bye. And with all that said and done, we have made it up to the end of this update. Before I go, I want to thank each and every one of you guys for watching. I also want to welcome any newcomers. I hope that all of you are enjoying my videos and what I do here. If so, you all know what to do. Leave a like, comment with your thoughts and opinions, share the video if you believe that it deserves to be shared, or even consider subscribing for more builds to come. Until the next time, fellow modelers and friends, take care and model on. It was that Mofo Damon, signing out.